This video tutorial I will explain S2 in-memory database. Here you can see Springboot application. Assume this Springboot application is connected to this MySQL database, and this MySQL database is used by other team members for development and testing. And suppose you are developing a new functionality and you should not corrupt the MySQL database with test data, or you should not delete some data from MySQL database. In that case, you can use S2 in-memory database. So using S2 in-memory database, you can test how your new functionality is working and testing your code with various test cases. S2 in-memory database is very easy to set up and very easy to use. And we can insert the data and we can delete the data from S2 in-memory database as many times we want. And it will not impact the team members. And it will not impact the real-time database which is used by other team members for development and testing. And all the data which is stored in in-memory database stays in memory. And once application is stopped, all the data will be deleted or cleared out. And when we start the application, there won't be any data in in-memory database. And we can start the testing from scratch. And S2 in-memory database is Java SQL database, and it is lightweight. And we can quickly integrate with Spring Boot project. Here you can see the login page of S2 in-memory database console. And S2 database, we can use it in embedded mode or server mode. Embedded mode is nothing but like a in-memory database. And to connect in-memory database, we have to give a driver class, JDBC URL, and username and password. By default, username is SA and password is empty. And if you want to change username and password, that is also possible. Here you can see H2 database console, and here you can write the queries to get data from the particular table. And using this console, we can see the table structure. And also using H2 database console, we can connect to standalone database. Like if you want to connect to MySQL database, or if you want to connect to Oracle database, that is possible using S2 database console. Now we will see how to configure S2 in-memory database in Spring Boot application and how to sign into S2 in-memory database. First, what we have to do is in pom.xml, we have to add S2 database dependency. This dependency, we have to add it in the pom.xml file. Here you can see Spring Boot application. In pom.xml file, S2 database dependency has been added. Next, what we have to do is in application.properties file, we have to command the MySQL related configurations like this. And what we are planning to do is we are planning to connect this Spring Boot application to S2 in-memory database. So we have to enable S2 console like this. And Spring H2 console path, we have to add like this. Here you can see security constants.java, and here I have defined H2 console path. And this is the path we will use to browse H2 database in the web browser. And that time, it should not ask authentication. For that, what we have to do is in web security class configure method, we have to permit this H2 console path like this. And also we have to disable frame options like this. Now I am going to start the application, and application will connect to S2 in-memory database. And whatever initial tables are there, that will be created based on the domain class. And here you can see application has been started. And here you can see addresses table, users tables are created. To access in-memory database, we have to use this URL. After localhost 8080, we have to use context path, this one, then hstconsole path. Click on enter, and here you can see the login page of H2 database console. Select generic H2 embedded. Here you can see the driver class and JDBC URL, and username is SA, and password is empty. It is not needed. By default, this is the username and password is empty. Click on test connection and it is successful. Click on connect, and here you can see H2 database console, and here you can see users table with columns, and here you can see addresses table with columns. Click on this and select star from users. Run this query. Click on run, and currently it does not have any records. Now I am going to send request to this URL to create user and corresponding addresses. In the body, I am giving user information and the addresses. And HTTP method I am using post. Click on send. And here we got statuses 200 OK, and user is created. Run this query again, and here you can see the user is created, one row is created. Click on addresses. And two addresses are created, which are related to user ID 1, which is Julie. Now I am shutting down the server. So once the server is shut down, all the data in the in-memory database will be cleared out. I am restarting again. Refresh. And here you can see the user data is not there, because after shutdown all the data is cleared out. Here you can see the login screen, and default username is SA, and password is empty. Suppose you want to change default username and default password to some other username and password, then let's see how to do that. Shut down the server. Copy this Spring data source username and password. Username I am giving as Ram and password as Ram123. Save these changes. and start the application. Here username is SA, which is default username, and password is empty. Now check this by clicking on test connection, and we got wrong username or password. Now I am giving Ram as username and password as Ram123. And this time the connection is successful. Click on connect, and you can see the console. Now we will see using H2 console how to connect to MySQL database. Select generic MySQL. Username is root and password also root. Click on test connection and test is successful. Click on connect. Click on connect and it is successfully connected to MySQL database. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more, and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.